How's it going? Hypnotic here, bringing you another Smashtober video.
We only have 42 more days until the game's release, and what better way to end your day than to hear more Smash leaks? And as before, we do not know if these leaks are real or not. If you would like to read with me, then that's pretty cool, go ahead. But if not, then there's a link down in the description below to the actual website where you can find all the information right there. Okay guys, so remember that one leak the other day where we found 7 new fighters in the actual art for Smash Bros. Ultimate? If you don't remember that, or if you don't even know what it is, then basically what it is was some guy from France, I believe it was said to have leaked an entire 7 different characters on the, what's it called, the Smash art, that's what it is, the Smash art, and he was said to have leaked it there. Because he works in a place where he could have access to that information. And basically, that's just the gist of it right now. If you want a better explanation on how things went, you can go look at my other videos that were beforehand. They're just like literally, you can click on my channel and find it. It's really just right there. Anyhow, there have been a bunch of people that are trying to say that this leak could not be legitimate and can be disproven. Well, I have some information that might be able to say whether yes or no that it could be real or not. So please do stick around until the end for this one. Okay, so Eric Bricard was said to have been working at APC PLV and Marina PLV, and so everybody just naturally assumed that he was working at Marina PLV, but he hadn't been working there since 2016. Now, go ahead and you can read along with me, or if you want to, there's a link down in the description below. Again, I know I said that already once, but just to make sure that you're still with me. Okay, rumors of privacy leak on the latest version of the Super Smash Bros. Game report a link to our company. All these rumors only support one idea. Journalism is not limited to searching Google. Indeed, the person involved in this rumor, if so, is no longer present in our company since November 2016, which has not put its LinkedIn profile up to date. Some wanted to make an approachment with the Marina workshops that cannot exist. Namco is a company we have worked with and with which we want to work again. This is not the case currently for the launch of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. These rumors are therefore discrediting our widely recognized professionalism, particularly with regard to our confidentiality and commitments. We are now contacting all these sites at Namco/Nintendo to remove this false information and evaluate the judicial suits to be given. Signed, the Marina team. Okay, why don't we just talk about this a little bit, what we just read. Okay, so Marina PLV is being accused of leaking Smash content, or one of the workers from PLV, Marina PLV, has been accused of leaking Smash content from that company. However, they just came out and told everybody that they, or none of their workers, have leaked this information at all. And as far as Eric Bricard goes, he hasn't even been working there since 2016. So, could that be good enough grounds to say that this leak is totally and completely fake? But where did it come from otherwise? Well, the truth is, it could still very well be real, even considering the circumstances that we're in right now. Just because Eric Bricard has not been working there for over 2 years, it does not mean that it wasn't him. It doesn't, and just because they said that it wasn't anyone from their company, it does not mean that it was not Eric Bricard. After all, it was brought back to him. It obviously had to come from somewhere if it was not from that company. And you probably guessed it, it came from APC PLV, and he's been working there for, like, I don't even know how long. All I know is that that's one of the places that he worked, and that's the only place that really hasn't been mentioned much. You know, truth be told, had people been going to APC and jumping down their throat, perhaps things would have turned out a bit differently in this case. Now, that is just one possibility, which could be very open-ended, but I think I have a little more proof that I can show to you guys that might make a bit more sense. There's a video on Wendy's tailgate tour saying that Smash Brothers will be playable in certain locations, and it was posted on Nintendo's Twitter. And I'm just gonna show you the video and see if you spot anything that is different than normal.
What's going on, guys? It's your boy Hollywood. I'm hanging out here at the Wendy's College Tailgate Tour, and we're playing Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. It's an absolutely amazing game, exclusively on the Nintendo Switch. Doesn't even launch until December 7th, but guess what? We are playing this thing early and with you guys out here on a 10-city tour, and these guys are having an absolute blast playing the game. This is the single largest collaborative game in Nintendo history. You're talking over 30 different franchises that come together with over 60-plus characters to make this game. Can't wait to have some fun with you guys playing Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Until next time, see you later. Peace.